Yeah. So I said, I'm 38. I got back into running at around 32. It's completely out of shape. I lost a fair amount of muscle in my calves from sitting around. And then when I decided to go running, I said, I want to protect my knees, so I'm going to try mid and fourth strike, you know, landing on the ball of your foot or your toes, or at the minimum, the middle of your foot, not your heel. You can't run barefoot on pavement with no shoes on and heel strike. You're only able to do that because of the cushioning in modern shoes. The way that I switched over was that I ran in barefoot shoes while I was transitioning. I did tear my calf a couple times because I'm an idiot and I push too hard. I don't take enough time off. And then it forces me to take time off. So I'm just going to do a little demonstration of toe strike and mid strike. And you know, you're able to switch back and forth. Once you tune into your feet, I don't listen to music when I'm running. I listen to my breathing, trying to get my pace right. I feel my feet. And if my calves are getting tired, I can switch to mid strike. Give them a rest while I keep running. So it's gonna be a soft heel touch. So you're gonna land on your toes, but you're gonna still touch down. And then mid strike is just flat. Not heel, 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 heel. Not like that. Flat. Or up on your toes, get those calves pumped. If you're an older runner and you're having knee issues, or you just want to protect your knees, your calves are the largest shock absorber in your body. So I absolutely enjoy running more now that I'm a toe strike runner, who can actually swap over to mid or heel because I'm in tune with my feet and I've practiced all three. Heel's natural to me and I've practiced the other two. The other thing is for trail running, running up mountains, even hiking, you're on your toes the whole time. You don't have a choice because you're going uphill. And then on the way down, if you don't have the calf strength to land on your toes when you're hiking down a mountain, especially on the East Coast, like when I used to descend Mount Adams, everything is so steep that there's a ton of shock going into your knee joints. However, if you train yourself to land on your toes, your knees no longer absorb, your knees and your shoes are no longer your shock absorbers. Stay soft, motherfuckers.